sweet as money earned! Twice as sweet as money earned! Alright! Take them!
Take them all!
Idiots! Get off the-
Thank you, Munchly! Booyah! Yeah! Twice as sweet as money earned! Twice as sweet as money earned!
I hope you get cancer! You can only get cancer!
See, it's not a nice way to talk. What?
I can't believe I had to get out of line at Taco Bell for this? I mean, your outfits don't even match. How hard is it to get your outfits to match? What is that thing you're holding? Oh, good. For a second there, I thought you were going to try and shave me. And that would be just weird. But seriously, you guys should be ashamed of yourself coming out in public like this. I'm embarrassed to even be here. Yeah, I had a feeling you were going to say that. Do you guys know I fight guys with morphing metal arms and actual electrical power? I'm A-list, baby. I'm a merchandising empire waiting to happen. And you? You can't even come up with a coherent group fashion statement. I'm not saying you have to put on the tights. Tights aren't for everyone. And by the looks of most of you, tights would definitely be a bad move. But if you expect to be taken seriously by guys like me, you're really going to have to work on your presentation. And may that be a lesson to all of you youngsters looking to get into the not-so-lucrative field of having a guy like me conk you one on the head! Oh, never mind. I'm late for class.
Today, we're going to knock our brilliant heads together, and we're going to discuss moles.
Hot roof! Hot roof!
And of course, I don't have to tell any of you this because you've all read your chapters. But the mole is the amount of substance of a system which contains as many elementary entities as there are atoms in 0.012 kilogram of carbon 12. When the mole is used, the elementary entities must be specified as what? Well, they may be atoms, molecules, ions, electrons, other particles, or specified groups of such particles. The number of atoms in 12 grams of carbon 12 is around 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd power atoms. And this value, 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd power, is also known as what? Anyone?
What? Sorry.
Would the esteemed Mr. Parker like to share with us what could possibly have caused his tardiness to this class that I worked so hard to prepare?
Sorry.
I asked you a question, Mr. Parker.
I fell asleep?
We were just discussing moles, Mr. Parker. And I asked what the value of 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd power is also known as.
Avogadro's number.
Can you tell me how many moles of atoms are in one mole of methane?
5.1 carbon and 4 hydrogens. One carbon and 4 hydrogens.
Yes, that's right. Very good, Mr. Parker.
Oh man, Peter!
I know.
All the channels were carrying the Kraven thing live.
I know.
I was sitting there watching you on TV.
Shh!
Watching you fight that guy with the arms.
I know. Keep it down.
Did you hear what happened to that Kraven the Hunter?
No. What?
They canceled his TV show.
Really?
Saw it on the Today Show this morning. They put it on indefinite hiatus. And I have an uncle who's a PA at NBC, and he says that's French for sayonara, sailor.
The French say sayonara, sailor?
You got his show canceled.
Well, now he really has a reason to hate me.
I smell sequel. It was scary watching you like that.
Whisper.
But, I don't know, kind of exciting.
Yeah?
I never saw you like that before.
Shh.
No one can hear us.
Well, for the record, That was about as intense as it's ever gotten.
Really?
Yeah.
Hey, I called you yesterday, you know.
I know.
Your aunt seemed ticked.
Yeah, well, that's in direct result of her actually being super majorly ticked.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
What happened?
What happened is she caught me sneaking in at 3 o'clock in the morning.
3?
I was fighting that Doc Ock idiot all the way in Jersey, right? It took, like, forever to get home. So she's up waiting for me when I get home.
No way.
She asked me where I was. I went, and she blew a gasket.
Oh. You know, she called me that night, and I told her you were at the library like you told me to.
And I blew it and told her I was at the Bugle.
Oh, man.
Not your fault.
So what happened?
I'm grounded.
No.
Oh, yes.
For how long?
What time is it now?
1:30.
Oh, good. Then I'm only grounded for 99 more years.
Seriously?
She's so mad.
Really?
Like I have never seen.
Can I come over then? We'll just hang out at your place.
No.
No?
You are the entire foundation of the grounding. And I think I'm going to totally lose the Bugle job, too.
No.
Yes. In fact, I think I might have to hang up the webs for a while, too. I tried to get some swing time in at lunch, but you saw. I was late to school, and I missed lunch, and now I'm starving. I guess I'm just going to have to lie low.
Wow.
I know. Guess I'll just catch up on my reading and keep making boo-boo kitty faces at Aunt May until she gives in.
This stinks. How long, really?
I don't know.
This stinks.
I haven't been grounded since I was 7 years old. It used to be... Uncle Ben would have calmed her down for me. But with him not here, I don't know what I have to do. She knows I lied, and I can't tell her the truth.
Make something up.
Too late for that. At this point, I'd need proof, and I don't have it. It's a freaking mess. Will you wait for me?
No.
No?
No, because I'm coming over.
No.
Yes!
No.
I'll sneak over.
No.
Seriously?
Not if you ever want to see me again.
I can't sneak over.
No.
You can have a whole secret superhero thing and I can't come over?
I really want to respect my aunt. She said some things that...
Okay.
It won't be forever.
Well, guess we'll just have to make out under the bleachers during school then.
Yep. Yes, we will.
Oh my god.
Harry! I can't believe it!
Harry Osborn? Oh my god, Harry!
Surprise!
What are you doing here?
I go to school here.
But...
Listen. It's a long story. But I went through a rough patch, as you well know. Some stuff I didn't understand, but I'm really okay now.
You're back at school?
I am back.
Just like that?
No, but I'm here.
Well, looky looky. Harry Osborn, back from the dead.
Flash.
What? No hug for me?
No, no hug for you. See Peter and Mary here? See? Guess what they did while I was away that you didn't?
Hit puberty?
They wrote me. They wrote and they called. Why? Because they are actually my friends, who care about me, as opposed to you, who's all like, out of sight, out of mind.
I thought about it, I just didn't get to-
Don't sweat it, Flash.
So what, now you're joining the dweeb squad?
Has he come out yet?
What?
Have you come out of the closet yet?
What?
I've had a lot of time to think things over, and it's pretty obvious, Flash.
What?
He hasn't come out yet?
No.
Stop it!
You know, I thought you were when I first got here.
You be quiet, serial killer lady! All I need is to listen to this from two geeks, a nutjob, and a serial killer! All y'alls can kiss my backside!
But guys first, right?
All y'all!
Gwen Stacy?
Yeah. Do we know each other?
No, no. I'm Harry Osborn. I was just in the principal's office getting readmitted, and the guy said there's a new girl here to watch out for. You just gotta be her.
Principal said that? You just made my entire week.
So, this is it? You're back in school?
I'm back in school.
You seem okay. You seem really okay.
Well, things are gonna be different, but I'm really glad to see you guys.
I'm so glad you're back!
Hey, Peter, listen. My father wants you to come over for dinner tonight.
Your father?
I thought you said your father was...
He's fine.
But you said...
I had, like... It's hard to describe. But I kinda... had an episode because my mom died in that fire. You know, I saw her die, and... my brain, I just wasn't processing it right, and I... well, I freaked out. I couldn't deal with my mom dying. I couldn't deal with the accident my dad was in. My wires got kind of crossed for a bit. But my dad's fine. I'm fine.
But that thing that attacked our school, you
yeah,
said it...
Yeah, well, I don't know what that was. But it wasn't my dad. That was just an unrelated bit of crazy that I mixed in with all the crazy I was going through. Listen, I have a whole new view of the world. No more drama. No more trying to be anything other than what I am. And plus, me and my dad are super close now. It's really great. And the first thing that he asked me to do is get you to come over for dinner. Can you come into the city?
I can't. I'm grounded.
Grounded? Since when did you get grounded?
I'm grounded.
Okay, well, hey. I'll tell him some other time, then.
Ah! I knew this would happen! I knew it! You don't just get powers like these. Everything comes back to bite you. Harry's dad knows I'm Spider-Man. He knows! And I don't care what Harry thinks. That goblin thing that trashed our school was his dad. I saw his face. I looked into his eyes. That was him. It had to be. He said my name. No, wait. Don't be a paranoid freak for 2 seconds. Look at it the other way. Say Harry is right. And that goblin thing had nothing to do with anything other than just some random mutant crazy. It's not like I haven't seen enough random crazy mutant stuff in my short life as Spider-Man. And his dad... well, his dad holds the answers to all my questions. He knows I got my powers in an accident at Oscorp Labs, and maybe he can help me with them, right? Maybe this is the beginning of a real turnaround for me. The next chapter. I'm kidding myself. God, stop it! Just stop it! This guy is a worm. You read everything about him and his business, his discoveries. He's a skeeve. Even if he didn't turn himself into a mutant goblin, he's a piece of garbage. And all of a sudden, Harry and him showing up right after I help put Octavius away. I mean, the Monday after Doc Ock makes his final appearance, oh, all of a sudden, there's Harry and Norman Osborn. A big, happy family. Which is like the total opposite of what they were the last time I saw them. Nah, this is crap. Big crap. Thing is, even if he turned into the Pope, Norman Osborn has me by the good and plenties. I am so entirely screwed. I don't know what Harry's dad wants from me, but I know I don't want anything from him. I just want to go to school and be Spider-Man when I want and go to a good college. And Mary Jane? God, I'm just so entirely crazy about her. Today? I swear, I could have married her today. Should I tell her that? Because I would. I would marry her. Well, as much as I hate being grounded and not being able to hang out with her, at least it gives me an excuse to stay away from the Osborns until I can get my head together.
Hi, sweetie.
What's going on?
Did you see the limo outside? Harry's father sent it for you. You didn't tell me they were back in town.
I just found out.
Mr. Parker, I'm Miss Brooke, Mr. Osborne's personal assistant. A pleasure to meet you.
Did Mr. Osborne invite you for dinner?
Yeah, but...
You can go.
What?
The man sent a limo.
But I'm grounded.
You can go.
But...
Harry's back in town. A limo. This is a special occasion.
Mr. Parker, your chariot awaits. Oh, and Mr. Osborne says bring your knapsack. So, bring your knapsack.
Good. You'll do your homework with Harry. That's nice. We'll talk when you get home.
Ever been in a limo before?
Once, kinda.
Yes. Yes. No, he's with me now. Yes, sir.
So who's grounded now, huh?
You're nuts.
I think for the next week, we'll just park a limo outside your house till your aunt forgets you're grounded.
I can't believe you.
You don't say no to an Osborne. But this wasn't me. This is my dad. Told you he wanted to see you.
You know why?
Nope. Probably wants to buy you to be my friend. What's your quote?
Cut it out.
I can't believe you and Mary Jane are an item.
Who told you that?
Mary. I just talked to her for like an hour.
She's here?
No, phone. Good Lord, is she in love with you.
Did she say that?
What?
That she was in love with me.
Well, yeah.
She used those exact words?
She hasn't told you that yet? Guess I kinda let the cat out of the bag.
What else did she say?
She's pregnant. Ah. Well, you're still easy pickings. At least that hasn't changed. So how about we double date?
With?
That Gwen Stacy. Holy gololy, that is a fine addition to the universe. What's she like?
She's...
Oh, here we are. Top floor.
This is where you live?
Yeah, I like it.
No duh. But why are you going to school in Queens then?
Because I want to be with you guys. Listen, I have to finish up with my therapist. He's mad at me because I walked out to come meet you. I'm not supposed to do that. My dad's in there. Just knock.
Wait, what?
My dad wants to talk to you over there. I'll be in my room back here. Just come meet me when you're done with whatever.
Your doctor?
Yeah, we just talk and stuff. No biggie.
Mr. Parker.
I feel like I'm going to faint. Whatever this is, I'm not ready for it. I'm not prepared. But think. Come on. There's too many people here for anything bad to happen. Harry's here. Whatever this is, it is. Mary loves me? Holy crap. I should hop right out the window. I should run away so no one can find me. I should tell Aunt May the truth and find Mary and run away. No. This... whatever this is, it is. Face it.
You are a nuisance and I will have no more.
See, look at this. You don't have to be a lunatic. You could rent yourself out as a children's ride. You don't have to be all...
I've watched this clip so many times this weekend, I thought I was gonna burn a hole in my TiVo. So, how do I look? Better or worse than the last time you saw me? So, you got it out of your system, I hope.
Got what out of my system?
This Spider-Man crap. You're done.
What's going on here? How are you alive? What's going on?
What's going on is I own you. You're you because of me. You know it, I know it. You certainly don't think I'm gonna let you run around dressed like that. It's embarrassing, it's childish, it's just ill-conceived. I appreciate the spirit, the gung-ho-ness of it all. But you're done. Your little teeny-bopper agenda is of no interest to me. It's over. We have bigger things to discuss. As for how I'm alive... I've evolved. Okay. Watch this. The little scientist in you is gonna get goosebumps. Hold on. Now, what was your question?
God! What am I going to do?
Okay. Just so we know who's in charge.
Dad, it's here!
You right there, Harry? Oh, poor Harry. Everyone around him has a little secret identity, and he has no clue about any of it. He doesn't know about the circles. Poor kid. So much like his mom, living with her head in the sand. So busy protecting our lifestyle that she never had a life. Actually, that's hardly a fair comparison. Harry's mother used 12-year-old Scotch to delude herself into a haze, while Harry only needs the best hypnosis money can buy. A little time out in the Colorado mountains with our good Dr. Warren, and Harry gets to put all the confusing elements of his life away in a little box, put high on a shelf, to be all good and forgotten. I tell you, the boy's really turning around. Best money I ever spent. This is the worst part.
Where was I? Oh, yes, Harry. No, Harry doesn't know that his dad's the next step in human evolution. Or that his best friend is, I mean, was, Spider-Man. No, not yet. Maybe one day when he's ready, when I feel the boy can handle his true destiny as an Osborn. But for now, it's our little secret. Our bond as men. Our first of many, Peter.
Dad!
Because from this day forward, now and forever, you belong to me. You work for me. You do as I say. And for that, you will be rewarded. Your future in this world will be a fine one. One worthy of your budding intellect and power. There may be some things you have to do that you might not agree with. Some decisions I make that you don't understand. And even though you may not appreciate my grand vision just yet, you will obey me. Because if you do not, well, first I will torture and possibly murder your dear auntie. I'll probably do it right in front of you. Or maybe I'll just destroy your little girlfriend, Mary Jane, right? Then I might delight myself in beating you to the edge of death. Not to death, just the edge of death. I will let you try and heal. I will watch you struggle through the broken bones and the severed nerves and tissues. And most probably, you will heal. And then, just as you begin to feel yourself becoming human again, I will beat you to death.
Dad!
Do we understand each other? Good. Let's go.
Feast your eyes, baby. It's the Dateline piece. They sent an advance copy. It's airing Friday night, but you get to see it first.
Oh, you'll like this, Peter. It'll bring you up to date on the traveling Osborns.
What's with the rope, Dad?
I was taking a sauna.
You and your sauna. Okay, everybody, ready? My national television debut, or as I like to call it, guaranteed Tookie Magnet.
Tonight we bring you the strange and wonderful journey of Norman Osborn. Anyone who read the financial section of a newspaper in the late 90s knows the name and face of Norman Osborn. He burst onto the lucrative scene of bioengineering with a series of breakthroughs that brought his company to the forefront of the new sensory sciences. All culminating into the announcement of Oz, the latest IT product to send Wall Street into a tornado of activity. A product whose purpose was kept a mystery, but whose existence brought a financial windfall to everyone who bet on it. Oscorp was now a major player. But all that changed last November, the day of the accident that destroyed one of Oscorp's major facilities, killing dozens of its employees, and maybe even Norman Osborn himself. The fate of Norman Osborn and his latest invention became a mystery as well. What was Oz? And where did it go? Were the reports of Norman Osborn's death true? Without answers, as quickly as Osborn's star skyrocketed, it disappeared. But was Norman Osborn's death a fake, or was it all a cunning disappearing act? And if so, why? The rumors went flying, but no answer ever came. Until tonight. Tonight, for the first time anywhere, Norman Osborn, alive and well, speaks. He has come out of hiding, out of self-made retirement, to speak about the fateful night that destroyed his life, and about how he plans to rebuild his life and company again from the ground up. So, Norman, where have you been?
The explosion at our main facility was a devastating eye-opener to me. Not only had we lost the lives of some of the most dedicated and brilliant American scientific minds, it endangered the life of my only son in the process. Luckily, we both escaped the explosion by the skin of our teeth.
Do you believe the explosion was sabotage?
I absolutely do. I believe that my competition with Justin Hammer was somehow responsible for both the death of my wife and the sabotage of my plant. I'd gone into hiding to protect my son and myself, hoping and waiting for the authorities to catch up with this vicious maniac.
And with Justin Hammer dead?
Yes.
You feel it's safe to come out of hiding?
I do. Like any parent, I believe my boy deserves the best that life has to offer. And I believe the world deserves my best effort in making this a better place to raise our children.
And the reports that Otto Octavius, Dr. Octopus, was somewhat responsible for Justin Hammer's death.
You saw what I saw.
He used to work for you.
Yes, but we've
What's wrong, Peter?
Let him go, Harry.
But
you'll see him tomorrow.
I have no idea what's happened to him. But I assume that he came to the same conclusion about Hammer's involvement in the destruction of our lives.
How was your big limo ride, Mr. Rockstar?
Stank.
You okay?
No.
You didn't have a good time with Harry? I shouldn't have made you go if you didn't want to.
I'm sorry about Saturday night. I didn't mean to lie to you, Aunt May. I didn't mean to.
Okay. It's your first girlfriend. We'll just chalk it up to experience. Okay. My little man, there you are. Are you okay, sweetie?
It was a long day.
Sure. Did you eat?
God, what am I going to do?
Peter? It's Mary. Pick up if you can.
Mary?
Peter!
Hey.
Hey! Are you still grounded?
I don't know. I don't think so.
What happened? What's going on? What happened with Harry? Did you go over there? Was it all weird? Did he say anything about anything?
Is it too late for you to come over?
It's almost 11.
Man, I really need to talk to you. Some really horrible things.
What's going on?
Oh, man.
What?
Someone's here.
Where?
At my door.
Are you in the basement?
Yeah.
Who is it?
I think it's Harry.
At 11 o'clock at night?
Oh, man. Hold on. Gwen?
Wanna buy some Girl Scout cookies? No? Well, then, is it okay if I kill myself on your front lawn? What kind of freaky mad scientist lab thing do you got going on down here?
What are you doing here, Gwen?
No place else to go.
I'll call you back.
No, Peter, don't!
Sorry, I ruined your phone sex. Nice boxers.
Yes, you're allowed to use the phone, but it's after 10, so...
No, I got a problem.
What's up?
There's a girl in my basement.
A real one?
What?
Mary Jane is here, because that is really unacceptable
No, it's this girl from school, Gwen Stacy. She's kind of, you know. And she just came over here, like, out of nowhere. And I'm not even... She's the new girl at school. She said her mom ran off to Chicago with some guy or something, and her father's at work, and I don't know. I think she's thinking of hurting herself or something, and I don't know what to do.
She's here, right now.
Right here. Right now.
Okay. Put on some pants.
Oh my god, these are... oh my god, these are so...
When was the last time you ate?
I forget to, is all.
Girl has to eat.
That's what I tell her.
Captain Stacy?
May Parker, thank you so much for keeping an eye on Gwenny.
She's a terrific girl.
But I am so sorry for the imposition.
No, don't give it a thought. Everyone's life has static. If they didn't, I guess you wouldn't have a job.
True.
Eggs?
And then her father, the cop, came over and he had eggs. And then he and Aunt May had a talk in the other room about whatever, who knows. And I fell asleep at the kitchen table as Gwen went on about how she thinks Iceman is the hottest...
Your aunt made eggs in the middle of the night?
I think it's an old hippie thing. I don't know.
Why do you think she came over your house?
I don't know.
You never called back.
Listen, I need to tell you something more important than any of this. See, thing is, I did go over to Harry's place in the city last night, you know? Before all of this other crap, and it was entirely insane because...
Hey! Oh, it's my own personal superhero! What?
The spiky thing on your jacket!
Sorry.
Looks like you're doing much better.
I'm freaking exhausted. Are you kidding me? After we left your place, my dad and I had a whole big talk and stuff. It was good, but now I am a zombie. I'll just tell you about it later, if you care, but I just wanted to tell you that, well, that you rock and your aunt rocks too.
Not the word I would use, but I will tell her.
I'm serious. She's the best thing in this entire whole of a city. Hold on to this one, MJ. Solid gold.
Hey, have you seen Harry yet?
No.
Listen, I have to tell you.
Peter Parker, please report to classroom 222. Please report to classroom 222. Thank you.
What now?
Can you just hold on for a second?
I'm going to miss my trait quiz. I'll see you after class. I'm not grounded anymore. And I need to tell you something.
Hi, Peter. My name is Dr. Bradley. We've met before. Please, please sit down.
Oh, wait. You're that counselor lady, right? Well, I really don't have time to do this today. I have a trait quiz in 10 minutes,
and... This will only take a couple of minutes.
But I... Really, I'm fine. I'm not in need of any trauma counseling or...
Please, sit. So, I hear the Osbournes have come back to New York City.
Yes, 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 but...
You went over to their penthouse last night. Did Norman Osborn reveal his new abilities to you?
Wait, what is this?
If you could just answer the question, Peter.
What is this?
Did he threaten you? Did he tell you that he is aware that you are Spider-Man? Peter?
There's someone else in this room, isn't there? Who are you people? What's going on?
Peter?
I want to know what's going on!
Do you want to take it from here, sir?
Calm down, Hotshot. We have important things to talk about, and not much time to do it in. My name is Nick Fury. Have you heard of me? I asked you, have you heard of me?
Yes.
Then you know that I run the largest world peace task force in the world, SHIELD.
Yes.
Did you read the piece on me in this month's Time magazine?
No.
It's a cover story.
What are you doing in my high school? How do you know who I am?
Peter, there's not much in this world I don't know.
How do you know?
Agent Bradley, how do we know about Peter exactly?
Let's see. A bunch of ways. The Osborne Industries security tape, Otto Octavius hypnosis transcripts, the Latverian assault at the UN.
Oh, man.
Consider it flattering. We're busy people, but we've been keeping a good eye on you. You're a modern medical miracle, Peter. Someone like you is of incredible interest in this complicated world. But that said, I normally wouldn't even approach you like this, because as interesting as your case is, you are a minor, and we have no jurisdiction over you yet. But with Norman Osborn rearing his conceited head again, it's time we had a talk.
I would like to see some form of identification.
Haha, you're cute. Like what? A badge? A secret agent badge? Peter, Osborn is gonna have you kill me. And if you refuse, he's gonna try to do something bad to you. Like he said, kill your aunt, or whoever this Mary Jane Watson person is.
Girlfriend.
Man. So, sit.
Why would Osborn want to kill you?
Originally, the entire Oz Project, the genetic project that accidentally created you and Norman's alter ego, was being created for us, for S.H.I.E.L.D. We had, for many years, been taking open corporate bids on a super soldier serum. Oscorp and a few other companies were competing for our attention. Osborn made a heck of a presentation, but as it turned out, he was full of bull. All smoke and mirrors. His formulas were a mess. He was rushing his processes and getting sloppy. After 2.5 years, he had nothing to show for it. So I cut the cord between S.H.I.E.L.D. and Oscorp. He was and is pretty ticked off at me. Oh well. See, now he had a whole lot to answer for. His company was built on a genetic house of cards and it was about to tip. So to cover his hiney, he publicly declared that he had accidentally discovered some new thing, some new it, that was going to make the world stand up and cheer. And the truth is that he might have been onto something with Oz, but he had nothing yet. His announcement was about 7 years premature. He was scrambling, and your spider accident only tickled his backside more. So close, yet so far. He was arrogant, he panicked, got cocky, and turned himself into a monster. Flash forward to now. He is angry at everyone but himself for what he has done to his home, his company, his mind. Obviously, he has riddled his once brilliant mind with multiple mainline exposures to his untested genetic concoction. And, as our staff psychologists have projected, he's engaging himself in you, and us, and me, in a vicious cycle of delusion, revenge, and dominance.
So if you know this, arrest him. Shoot him. What do you want from me?
You're young, and I know you have a hard time understanding the bigger picture here. But legally, Osborn is off limits to us. Yes, we know all about Norman Osborn. We know all about his Oz Project. And we know what he has done to himself in an attempt to recreate the accident that created you. But...
Wait. He did that to himself because he wanted to...
Yes.
I didn't know that.
The American government isn't allowed to spy on Americans on American soil. It's against the law. I'm not here. Agent Bradley isn't here. It is, in fact, illegal for us to have heard his threat to you last night.
So what are you going to do to stop him?
Actually, kid, I came here to tell you that, for now, you're on your own.
What?
We can't touch Osborn until he actually does something wrong.
What? He threatened me and my-
Yes, but we technically don't know that.
He killed his wife.
We don't know that.
We sure do.
Oh, do you have forensic evidence to back that up? Because I don't.
Forensic?
It's scientific evidence that connects-
I know what it is. He threatened my family. He turned himself into a
We don't know that he threatened your family because we aren't supposed to be eavesdropping on him. And get this. The act of turning yourself into a goblin monster isn't illegal unless doing so infringes upon the rights of another. But we're working on that.
But he attacked the school!
No proof it was him.
How can you say that?
Our psych evaluation and intel says he will come to you, and he will order you to kill me. I would appreciate it if you say no.
But my aunt...
You say no. We will be watching and waiting. He will either engage you in conflict right there, or he will go after one of your loved ones. The second, the very second he crosses the line to threaten a civilian, we will be there to back you up.
You will be there after he goes after my aunt?
It's the way it has to be.
After?
It's the way it has to be.
And what if you're not there?
We will be there.
And what if you're not? See what I'm saying?
We will be.
You weren't here at the school that time. You weren't there when he killed his wife. You weren't there when he...
The other important thing is that it's probably wise that you not tell your family or friends anything about this.
What?
Telling them will only complicate matters. They will what? Run to the police? The media? What will that do? Save them from Osborne's dementia? Will it make it go away? No. At this point, telling them anything more than they already know will only put their lives in even graver danger. Knowledge kills.
I want you people to leave me the fuck alone! You hear me?
We will be there, Peter. You have to have a little faith.
I didn't ask for any of this. I wish I never even got these powers. Nothing. Nothing is worth the amount of absolute bullshit I have had to deal with. All I want is to, you know, go out with my girlfriend. Go to a nice college.
Peter, optimism is a revolutionary act.
Who told you that? The guy who poked out your eye?
Yes.
Sorry.
Don't worry about it.
Peter!
No!
Peter?
What's going on here? Huh? What is this?
Mr. Osborne invited us into the city for dinner. I thought you were coming with Harry.
Listen, I don't want to do this.
Do what?
I don't want you involved in this thing with them.
What are you talking about?
Norman Osborne, he isn't a nice man, Aunt May. He might be a criminal.
Really?
I did some research on him, you know, on the web, and you know, he disappeared and reappeared. Something weird is going on with him, and I think he's, like, a shady guy, and I don't want to be friends with Harry and have that in our lives.
Never met a man with money who hadn't stepped on someone to get it.
What?
Something Ben used to say.
Is everything okay?
Yes, but I'm sorry. I think we're going to have to make it another time.
That's too bad. Mr. Osborne was looking forward to meeting you.
Another time, maybe.
Another time, then.
So, what are we going to do tonight?
I have to go to work. This is it! Aunt May's my only family, and she's a lot more important than this stupid costume and these stupid powers. And if this is what my life as Spider-Man has come to, it's over. That's it. This is my last hurrah. And screw that Nick Fury guy. My aunt's being loaded up into that maniac's limo, and where is he? And I don't see him now. I'll run to the cops. I'll run to the FBI. I'll pull off my mask, and I'll say or do whatever it takes to get Osborne away from me and my aunt. And if I go to jail for it, fine. If I get publicly crucified for it, fine. I'll do whatever it takes, but I won't let another maniac hurt my family.
I thought I told you to throw that costume away.
I thought you drowned in the East River. Guess we're not as bright as we think we are, huh?
So, I take it you're going to choose the road most bloody.
What did I do to you exactly? Why are you in my life?
What did you do to me?
Man, you did this to yourself. Hello? I had nothing to do with this thing you turned yourself into. And I have nothing to do with you. If anybody should be mad at anybody, I think I should be mad at you. It was your spider. I should sue the crap out of you. What do you think of that? I don't want any part of this. I don't want to be a part of whatever it is you are up to. Do you even know what it is you're up to? Do you even know why you're picking on me?
Circles. Circles of life. Circles of death. Circles of hell. Circles of pain. Circles of responsibility.
Oh, man, whatever! You're such a jackass! All that crap you've injected into yourself has made you nuttier than a fruitcake!
You will do whatever I need. We share the same genetic codes. I own your genetics. I own you. Your responsibilities are to me.
That's all I need. A lecture in responsibility from you.
You will learn. You will learn what responsibility means.
Let's make this clear. I don't work with you. I won't get on your team. I won't kill for you. It's not going to happen. And so we are perfectly clear. I'm not scared of you. And if you come near my family, I will fight you till one of us isn't able to fight anymore. I'm serious. I have lost more people in this life than one person should. I didn't ask for any of this, but I won't let you do this. I won't. Leave me alone.
So be it. The same genes run through your blood as mine. You must learn your responsibilities to me. You will learn what responsibility means.
What are you talking about? I don't even know you.
You will learn.
Wow, Harry, that was so awesome. Now I know why people want to be rich and famous. I can get used to that.
Money doesn't buy everything, MJ.
But you can lease it with an option to buy.
Did you just make that up?
I stole it from somewhere. Hey, is Peter here yet?
Not yet.
He's coming, right?
My dad sent the car for him. I guess he'll be here soon. I have to talk to him. I've been acting really... Oh my god!
What is your name?
Harry Osborne.
Who is your father?
Norman Osborne.
What does your father do for a living, Harry?
He's a scientist and a biochemical engineer.
Do you know what that means?
Not really, but we're rich.
Does your father love you?
I think so.
He does, Harry. He loves you very much. How did your mother die, Harry?
In a fire.
Did you see it happen? Could you have saved her, Harry?
I don't know.
Your mother loved you, Harry. Your mother and father both love you. And with your mother gone, your father loves you twice as much. And when you wake up, you won't think of your mother or the fire. All you will feel is that fatherly love. And you will love your father right back. And awake. So, Harry, how are the rest of the students treating you now that you are back in school?
They, you know, some of them are fine. And others are weird.
What do you mean by weird, Harry?
I think it's the money, really.
You mean your wealth?
Yeah. I mean, I guess. I am the richest kid in school, but I don't care about any of those people, right? Anybody who's counting my money isn't my friend.
That's a pretty healthy attitude, young man.
Yeah? Thanks, Dr. Warren. In fact, my best friends are coming over for dinner tonight. You should stay and meet them.
Is this Peter and Mary Jane?
Yeah. MJ's been great. Peter's a little weird, but MJ swears up and down that he's going through a lot of personal crap at home, so I can relate.
What do you mean by that, Harry?
Joke. Man, is it that time?
The hour blew right by.
It always does.
That's a sign of a good session.
You always say that. My friends will be here any minute, so can I...
Go have fun. Harry is doing very well, Mr. Osborne. The suggestions are holding. He hasn't had a nightmare in 2 weeks. He is settling into school very well. His friends are of great comfort to him.
And the program words?
They're still there, but...
Did you test them?
No, I wanted to discuss...
Fine. Excuse me, Doctor. What's happening? What is the Parker boy doing now? No, just come back here without them. Okay.
At some point, we'll have to discuss the long-term effects of Harry's...
Will you excuse me, Doctor?
Mr. Osborne, I really feel that your son should...
Doctor, you are paid handsomely for a specific service.
Yes, sir.
I thought you drowned in the East River. Guess we're not as bright as we think we are, huh?
So, I take it you're going to first alone. Still, I
mean. What did I do to you, Jack? Why are you in my life?
What did you do to me?
You made you a god. Let me kill your daughter.
Man, you did this to yourself. Hello? I had nothing to do with this thing you turned yourself into. And I have nothing to do with you.
If anybody should be mad at anybody, I think I should be mad at you.
It was your spider. I should sue the crap out of you. What do you think of that? I don't want any part of this. I don't want to be a part of whatever it is you are up to.
Do you even know what it is you're up to?
Do you even know why you're picking on me?
Tell him of the circles.
Circles. Scratch my ass. Touch my head. Circles of life.
Don't tell
him. Circles of death.
Circles of hell.
Don't tell him.
Circles of pain.
Circles of responsibility.
Don't tell
him. Man, whatever! You're such a jackass! All that crap you've injected into yourself has made you nuttier than a fruitcake!
You DNA whatever I need. We share the same genetic codes. I own your genetics. I own you. I'm responsible for me.
That's all I need. A lecture in responsibility from you!
You will learn. One will learn. Responsibility means.
Let your make this clear. I don't work with you. I won't get on your team. I won't kill for you. It's not going to happen.
And so we are perfectly clear. I'm not scared of you. You come near my family. I will fight you till one of us isn't able to fight anymore.
I'm serious. I have lost more people in this life than... one person should. I didn't ask for any of this. But I won't let you do this. I won't! Leave me alone!
So be it. The same genes run through your blood as mine. You must learn your responsibilities to me.
It's coming.
You will learn what responsibility means.
What are you talking about? I don't even know you! Somebody! Somebody help me! Please! Somebody help! Nick Fury? Fury! Please! Are you out there? Help her! You've got to stop this! You've got to stop! Why are you doing this? Mary, are you okay?
Peter, please help me!
Circles, Parker. There they are. They would choose to destroy us both so my secrets die. Choose now, Peter. Choose.
Just let the girl... I'll do whatever you want.
Choose now, Peter.
Just give me the girl.
No!
Mary! I caught you! I got you! Mary...
Quartermain, this is One-Eye Eagle. Over.
I read you, General Fury.
I said I want constant updates on the Osborne situation. And what am I getting?
Sir, as you can see, Osborne has taken his hostage to the Queensboro Bridge. The Watson girl is being held out by her neck.
Is she still alive?
I think... yes.
What's the Spider-Man kid doing? I can't see shit. Can you take the shot?
Not without risking the girl. Osborne is holding her out by the head. Your call, General. Wait. Oh my god, he dropped her. The scum dropped her off the bridge and Spider-Man's diving after her.
Take the shot!
Copter one, confirm hit.
Hit confirmed.
Second round.
Hold your fire. Suspect is down.
Fury! It'll take a lot more than that.
Mary! Mary! I caught you! I got you! Mary! Oh, thank God! Are you okay? Are you hurt?
What's going on?
You fainted?
Where am I? What is that?
You've got to get out of here! Do you have any money?
No. Hey, no! I want to stay with you.
No. Get into a cab and get out of here. Go to my house. No, not my house. Go to that abandoned warehouse at Cruz and Third. Go there and hide. Go and hide until I come get you. You hear me? Do not go anywhere near my house or the Osbournes. You hide.
Okay, but I...
Promise me.
I promise.
Yo, Spider-Man. You rock.
Take her. Will you take her?
Oh, yeah. For you?
Get her as far away from here
Done.
As...
Done. You the man.
So lucky. So freaking lucky. Oh, man. I can't catch my breath. I almost lost her. Can't catch my... Osborne!
Yuri! Come face me. Plasma fields. Haven't even been ready for combat yet.
That's the least of your problems.
Hold your fire. All personnel, hold your fire until I give the word.
How dare you, Parker! I will have your head! I will eat you!
Oh, don't worry, Slappy. I'm not going anywhere. You really are a car-carrying, whacked-out-of-your-mind lunatic! You horror! You think I was just going to sit there and let you do this to me? To the people I love? I won't let you hurt anyone anymore!
Quartermain, what's going on?
He's beating the crap out of him.
Who is?
Spider-Man. Spider-Man's beating the living crap out of him.
There's nothing to you, Osborn, but hate. And selfishness.
There is more to me, boy. The man has the imagination to dream of.
I need a nap. Where's everyone going? Oh no. Harry! Osborn's hurt. Heading back to his penthouse. Gotta get there before he gets to Harry.
God is wearing off.
Done to my father.
Harry.
Dad?
Cellar door. Yes, Lord.
Drive home like that. You still in there, Osborn? Can you even hear me, you junky freak? This ends tonight. I'm not scared of you. One way or another. Tonight. To tell you the truth, Normie, I kinda like you more like this. At least I don't have to listen to your arrogant rant.
Dad! Oh my God! Peter?
Too big! My spine is bending! My boots are wet! I can't get a footing! He's too big now! I can't catch my breath! He's killing me! It's really... Somebody help me! He's laughing! No! Please! Stop laughing! No time to be fancy. No time to be cute. Just hit him with everything. Just win!
Peter?
I promise you. I will make you.
Dad.
No time to be fancy. No. The street below! The people! Got it! Got it. Okay. So stupid. This would have been my fault.
Osborn! The people below! Just let me... Please, let me... No!
Father, stop!
No!
Father!
The people below! You'll kill them! Just let me...
Father!
Harry, I...
Peter? Why are you... When did I... It's just something I...
Oh, Harry...
It's okay, kid. We're S.H.I.E.L.D. Agents under the command of Colonel Nick Fury. You alright?
Sir, the floor is secure.
Secure the area and start cleanup, ASAP, gentlemen. Don't make me say it twice. And get Carter up here to deal with local authorities. Well, how is he? Take care of him. He fainted.
Yeah.
Probably for the best. We'll take care of him.
Are you going to arrest him?
No, we don't do that. We'll deprogram the hackwork hypnotherapy, and then we'll do what we can to... You know, get him back to a normal life. It'll work out. We've seen worse. Told you, we would be there when it came down. Think of it this way, kid. One less injection, and Norman might have had enough wits about him to really do something horrible. I know it doesn't feel like it, but you dodged a bullet, and you did it with style. Quartermain, go into the Osborne kid's room and put together a casual outfit for Mr. Parker to wear home.
Yes, sir.
You want some gum? It helps with nausea.
No.
Buck up, kid. You saved the girl. Did the Watson girl make it back to Queens in one piece?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Pull recon out of there. All surveillance on the Parker kid is done.
Yes, sir.
Listen, you're young, and it will be hard to explain this to you. But the less you tell your girlfriend about all this, the better. I know it feels good to talk to a nice girl about all this crazy stuff you're going through. But every time you confide in her, you're inadvertently risking her life. There are just some things civilians aren't meant to know. My recommendation to you is, enjoy your youth. You're too young to be this involved with the big boys. There'll be plenty of time and opportunity for you here later.
Yeah, no offense, but it's hardly like I want any part of this big boys world of yours.
Well, you hardly have any choice, kid. You're an illegal, unnatural genetic mutation. You turn 18, you belong to me. That's the way it is. Unless you turn yourself into a menace to society. There's nothing we can do about you now. You're a minor, but when you turn 18... Kind of figured you figured that out already. Just try to enjoy your youth.
Hey. Sir?
Let him go. Them's the brakes, kid.
Mary? Mary? Psst. Oh, thank God. You okay?
No.
Are you hurt?
No, it was just... And I wanted to go home, but I did what you said.
Oh, man. Did you throw up?
Yes.
Why? Why were you there? Why did you go to the Osbournes?
I thought you were going to be there.
But I told you about Harry's father. I told you he was...
Peter, you didn't tell me anything. You told me you thought he was that monster thing. You didn't tell me you knew. Ever since Harry came back, you didn't say anything at all.
You didn't say anything at school today? You didn't tell me anything! How am I supposed to know that was going to happen?
Okay.
I would have done whatever you told me, but you didn't tell me any-
Okay.
What happened to Harry?
He's gone. Again.
What happened?
I don't want to talk about it just yet.
But-
Please?
But-
Would you still look at